For our first tutorial, let's have an overview of Nimbus. This is your robot. It is comprised of different devices, you know, hardware, the robotic platform, some sensors, actuators, and so on. It also has virtual components, software, drivers, and algorithms. And you probably composed some configuration that will allow it to sense, think, and act. You may have used ROS, the robotic operating system, to run it. But development and maintenance can get a little tricky sometimes, even for a single robot, let alone when you scale things up to use a fleet of robots. But here at Cogniteam, we've got you covered. Nimbus is our cloud-based framework and productivity toolkit for robot development, configuration, testing, and deployment. One of the main parts of the Nimbus system is the Nimbus Cloud Services. It hosts the Nimbus Hub, which is a great library of predefined devices and components which you can use to define your robot. It has the infrastructure needed for deploying and managing individual robots and fleets as well. Another part of the Nimbus system is the Nimbus Agent. When you add a new robot, you will get an installation line which will install the Nimbus Agent on your robot with all its required dependencies. The Nimbus Agent communicates with the Nimbus Cloud Services and provides access to the functionalities and services required by the robot. So you, as a user, can now command and control your robot using the Nimbus web application or directly using an SSH terminal. Going back to the Nimbus web app, robots, list your robots. You can group robots into fleets and view them here. And with dashboard, you can view your favorite robots. When clicking a robot, you can overview its entire status, perform teleoperations, view different streams in different ways, for instance, an emerging map of a laser scan or a camera view, and amend the configuration, and view event logs, etc. So how do you create a Nimbus component? Well, typically you will start with ROS, the robotic operating system. It's not a must, but you can download some ROS packages and define the things that you need. Then you wrap it up with a Docker, with a Docker file and a Docker image, and then you define a JSON file, and the user can now upload this whole thing to the Nimbus cloud. If it seems a bit complicated, don't worry, in the next tutorials, we're going to get into this in great detail. Here lies one of the great advantages of using Nimbus. When you're deploying some configuration and using Nimbus components, you don't really care if you're using ROS version 1 or ROS version 2 or not using ROS at all. It's already dealt with by using Dockers. So now you can go to components or devices and view the available items that you created or other users have created and shared. You can of course edit or create your own. And now you can use these devices and components to create configurations. You can compose your own configurations by simply connecting input and output streams of Nimbus components. And remember, behind each of these Nimbus components, algorithms or drivers, there's a Docker image, so you don't really care about the dependencies and so on. You can deploy your updated configuration with ease to your robot or your entire fleet. So, this is the Nimbus architecture, and in the next tutorials, we'll go through to each of these items with great detail. So see you in the next tutorials.